Hello friends, welcome to the video lecture series on digital image processing. I am Dr. Alpesh Dafda, and in this 29th video class of DIP, we will study Wiener filter in digital image processing and its implementation in MATLAB. So starting with the name Wiener filter, the Wiener filter has got its name from its inventor N. Wiener, and this Wiener filter is the most popular filter used for image restoration. From our previous video classes, we know that estimation using modeling can have three different cases. Case one is that when we have the full knowledge about the degradation function, and in that case we use inverse filtering that we have learned in the previous video class. When along with blur, noise is also present and we do not have the full knowledge about the degradation function, in that case we have to use Wiener filter. And when we do not have any knowledge about the degradation function, in that case we have to use the blind deconvolution. So we'll be learning Wiener filter and implementing it in MATLAB. So let us start. So we know from the model of image degradation and restoration process that the degraded image G of UV is equal to H of UV multiplied by undegraded image F of UV plus N of UV, where N of UV is our noise that is added to the image and H of UV is the degradation function that can be blur or artifacts. So our aim is to find out F of UV, that is undegraded image. So making F of UV as the main part of the equation, we get F of UV is equal to G of UV minus N of UV upon H of UV. So in the previous video class we saw that if the noise is not present, in that case we have the full knowledge about the degradation function and we apply the inverse filtering. But if the noise is also added to the image along with the blur, then inverse filtering will not work. Why? Because it may happen that H of UV may be very very small. At that time the noise tends to be infinite and our estimated image will be degraded largely with noise. In that case we cannot use inverse filter, so we have to go for Wiener filter. So the Wiener filter uses the statistical properties of the image and can be used to restore images in the presence of blur as well as noise. So this Wiener filter was proposed by M. Wiener in 1942, and it is also called minimum mean square error filter or least square error filter. So it is called minimum mean square error filter because in statistics and signal processing, the minimum mean square error or MMSE estimator is an estimation method which minimizes the mean square error or MSE, which is a common measure of estimator quality of the fitted values of a dependent variable. And what does this mean square error tell us? Mean square error measures the amount of error in statistical models. It assesses the average squared difference between the observed and the predicted values. Here the goal is to find an estimate of the restored image. Let us say our restored image is F cap of UV, such that the mean square error between the restored image and uncorrupted image, let us say F of UV, is minimized. See, always our estimate, that is F cap of UV, will be matching or will be tending towards F of UV, but it will never become F of UV, that is our uncorrupted image, because our estimated image will always be having some error. And what we will do here, we will try to minimize this mean square error. This means that it minimizes the overall mean square error. So Wiener filter will give a linear estimation of the original uncorrupted image. And see, when both noise and blur are present in the image, the Wiener filter will achieve a compromise between a low pass and a high pass filter, resulting in a band pass filter. So it will be rejecting both the low pass blurring and a high pass noise and will act as a band pass filter, and that is the reason why Wiener filter is so popular. The Wiener filter incorporates both the degradation function and the statistical characteristics of noise into the restoration process. So here not only the blurring will be considered, but will also consider the statistical property of noise, such as the mean value of the noise, power spectrum of the noise, etc., for the estimation of the undegraded image. So for the Wiener filter, our objective is to optimize the mean square error, as we saw in the definition, that is the mean square error between the undegraded image F and the estimated image F cap. So the mean error square should be minimized. So error square is equal to expected value of F minus of F cap whole square. So for designing this Wiener filter, we are taking some assumptions. Number one, the noise and image are uncorrelated. Number two, either the blurring, that is H of UV, or noise should have zero mean. So at least any one of them should have zero mean. But if neither of the two have zero mean, Wiener filter will also not work properly. And number three is that the gray levels in the estimate are the linear functions of the degraded image. Based on these assumption, the minimum error function is given in the frequency domain by the Wiener filter formula. So in these equations, f is our uncorrupted image, f cap is the estimate of our f uncorrupted image, e is the error measure which we are taking square, e dot is the expected value, h of uv is our degradation function, h star of uv is the complex conjugate of h of uv, modulus of h of uv whole square, as we know, is equal to the complex conjugate of h of uv multiplied by h of uv, our degradation function, sn of uv is equal to modulus of n of uv whole square, which is the power spectrum of our noise, and sf of uv, which is equal to modulus of f of uv whole square, is the power spectrum of our undegraded image. So here we are taking the power spectrum of the noise as well as we are taking the power spectrum of the undegraded image. So these are the statistical properties which we are using for the estimation. So in this equation we know h of uv and hence we also know h star of uv, and from these two we can know what is modulus of h of uv whole square, but we do not know the power spectrum of the noise. Why? Because noise is a random noise, as well as we do not know the power spectrum of the undegraded image. Why? Because we only have the degraded image, and from the degraded image we have to find the undegraded image, right? So these two are unknown for us. So in the next step, what I have done, I have taken out sf of uv and sf of uv from here. So here it will become modulus of h of uv whole square plus sn of uv upon sf of uv, and sf of uv will cancel out from the numerator as well as the denominator, right? In the next step, what we are doing? In the next step, we are multiplying and dividing by h of uv in the numerator and the denominator. So if you multiply in the numerator by h of uv, you will get h star of uv into h of uv, which will be equal to modulus of h of uv whole square. In the denominator, h of uv will remain, and say I will denote sn of uv upon sf of uv by k. So now in this final equation, you can see that h of uv is also known to us, and modulus of h of uv whole square is also known to us. G of uv is known to us because this is the degraded image that we have. So the only unknown term here is now k, which is equal to sn of uv upon sf of uv, that is the power spectrum of the noise upon power spectrum of the undegraded image. So using trial and error, we will be assuming different values of k, such that we get f cap of uv, which is close estimate of f of uv. Now from this equation you can see that if k is equal to 0, that means this term and this term will get cancelled out, and the Wiener filter will become a simple inverse filter, that is 1 upon h of uv. So in the formula of Wiener filter, this term is difficult to estimate, and the approximated formula is given like this, where we assume this term as k. And practically, k is chosen manually to obtain the best visual result. If k is equal to 0, it will behave like an inverse filter. Let us implement this Wiener filter in MATLAB. As usual, we are reading an image and subplotting an image in one of the portions. We are introducing a motion blur and storing it in a variable PSF, that is point spread function. So see, this point spread function name itself defines what it does. It is spreading the point, that means it is blurring it, right? And my blurred image will be given as a blurred, which is equal to IM filter of original image, point spread function, circular convolution. Now for estimation of the noise parameters, we are assuming noise mean is equal to 0 and noise variance is equal to 0.001, and signal variance can be estimated by variance of our original image, and using these two terms we will find out our noise to signal ratio. So you can see here, this is noise to signal ratio, that is our k, right? So noise to signal ratio is given by noise variance upon signal variance, and now I'll be adding the noise to my blurred image, and I'll be subplotting the noisy image in the second portion of the output plot, and we'll be naming it blurred plus noisy image. So now applying the Wiener filter, dd is equal to dconv Wiener a underscore blurred psf nsr dconvolves image a blurred using the Wiener filter algorithm, returning dblurred image dd. Psf is the point spread function with which a underscore blurred was convolved, and nsr is the noise to signal power ratio of the additive noise, or capital K. The algorithm is optimal in a sense of least mean square error between the estimated and the true image. And finally, I'll be plotting this estimated image in the final portion of the output plot. So let us run the program and see the output. So this is our original image, cameraman.tiff. To this original image, we have added the motion blur as well as we have added the Gaussian noise to the image. And this one is the blurred plus noisy image. So when we use the Wiener filter, we obtain the restored image like this. And you can see that the restored image is a good estimate of the original image. Now, although this Wiener filter is the most widely used filter, there are few drawbacks of this Wiener filter. Number one, the Wiener filter is not optimal when no information on the power spectra is available. Number two, the performance of the Wiener filter depends on the correct estimation of the value of K. In minimizing the mean square error, the Wiener filter tends to smooth the image more than what the human eyes would prefer. Also, the standard Wiener filters cannot handle rotational motion blur. Finally, Wiener filter performs poorly if both signal and noise are non-stationary. So due to these problems of Wiener filter, many a times these Wiener filters fails for the estimation of the correct image. So what is the solution to the problem of this Wiener filter? The solution is constrained least squares filtering, which we'll be learning in the next video class. So that is all for this video class. I hope you would have gained a good knowledge from this video class. Thank you very much.